Hello, welcome back to my channel, Charlie's Lessons, and I'm going to show you today how you can build a lesson for any of your students in no time using ChatGPT. When I'm teaching anybody, I always try to make the classes for them. So that's why I always try to find out what their likes and interests are in the very first class. When I've done that, I can then build lessons and a course that is based around their interests so that they enjoy the classes more. I've got a student called Pedro, and when I did my first class with Pedro, the one thing that he said he liked the most was Fortnite. Now, if you haven't heard of it, Fortnite is a video game that's really popular with the young people. There's not a lot of lesson material out there for games like Fortnite, and a lot of the time I'm having to make the material myself. But I don't get very far, and we usually have to move on to different topics, and that's when Pedro gets upset again. So you can imagine when I heard about this new AI software called ChatGPT, I thought, well, maybe I can use this to build lessons that are perfect for Pedro. Let me show you what I did. So here I am on the ChatGPT website, and I've just entered a prompt, which is write a text about Fortnite and how popular it is. So I wanted there to be a particular focus, which was on how popular it is. So I'm just going to press enter now. Okay, so now I have my text that is all about Fortnite, and Pedro is gonna love this. In this particular case, I can ask it to make it more complex or more simple. Depends on the level of your student. And this text is gonna form the basis of a lesson I'm gonna do with Pedro. Now, I'll ask ChatGPT to make 4 comprehension questions and 1 gist question. So a question that's going to test the overall understanding of the text. So now you can see I've got my 4 comprehension questions and my 1 gist question. Oh, I forgot, I need an answer key as well. Let's ask ChatGPT to give me an answer key. There you go, I've now got my 5 answers to the 5 questions we're going to set Pedro for this reading activity. If you like this idea in this video, then you should really go check out my tutorial video right here on ChatGPT on 4 other ways you can use it in your classroom. Now, with most English lessons, I'd like to spend a little bit of time focusing on an aspect of grammar with Pedro. And by reading this text, I've noticed there are lots of examples of the present perfect. What I've asked ChatGPT to do is to take 5 sentences from the text and include examples of the present perfect. So number 1, 3, and 5 contain the present perfect. So what I'll do in class is ask Pedro to identify the sentences that contain the present perfect. Now that Pedro has shown me that he recognizes the present perfect when compared to other sentences, I'm gonna ask him to complete a short gap fill activity. What I did here was I said, rewrite these 5 sentences with the verbs missing and a gap for the students to fill. And you can see here, I've got 5 sentences with the verbs missing. So we've done a reading task, a grammar task, and now I want to do some speaking activities with Pedro about Fortnite. I'm going to ask ChatGPT to write 5 conversation questions about Fortnite. So there are 5 questions I can use to get Pedro talking about Fortnite. Then we can take it in turn. So I'm going to ask him a question and then he can ask me a question. I don't know anything about Fortnite, but I'm just going to make something up. So now I've finished the speaking task and I think I'm going to give Pedro some homework because, you know, Pedro needs to do some homework every now and then, even though he says he doesn't want to. So my homework task is going to be to write a piece of text about Fortnite. So let's see. I'm going to ask ChatGPT to write 2 prompts for a writing piece on Fortnite. And there are 2 writing prompts for Pedro for his homework. And before we go home, I'm going to ask Pedro to choose 1 question. That's going to be good. I'm looking forward to what Pedro writes me if he does his homework. Now, if you're worried that Pedro is going to use exactly the same software to answer my homework question, then you'd be right. I'd be worried too. But that's why I made another video right here on how to detect AI text, especially if you're worried that you have students that are going to submit work used or produced by ChatGPT. Now, you're probably wondering, how do I get that material out of ChatGPT and into my lesson? Well, it's very simple. All I'm going to do is open a Google Doc document and just copy and paste the reading text, the questions and so on, so that they are in order of how we're going to do them in the lesson. So I've just opened a Google Doc document and I've got my ChatGPT history here. So I'm just going to find the text, which is just here. I'm going to copy and paste this and pop it straight into my Google Doc. Let's give this document a title first. So let's call this Fortnite Lesson for Pedro. And I'm gonna just give that a nice title. There we go, Fortnite Lesson for Pedro. Okay, now I need those comprehension questions, but first the gist question. Let's see, here is my gist question, just right here. Gonna pop this into here. And my four comprehension questions, which are just right here. So now I've got my reading text and my four questions. Now I've got my five sentences with some examples of the present perfect. Pop that in here. I'm just gonna add some titles so it looks a bit more professional. Is there something missing? The answers! Okay, here's the answer key for the reading questions, and I'm gonna pop this right at the end. And I'll just keep taking this from my ChatGPT history and paste that into the final page of the document so that the teacher has the answers. Thank you for watching this video. I think this software is really exciting, and I think there's a lot of potential for teachers to use this to make their jobs a lot easier. I'll see you in the next video.